At one point, Hezekiah was the first to be brave. He was the first to serve, the first to sacrifice, the first to give. But then over time, God began to lose the new car smell. He got busy in the ocean of life and stopped looking to the Father on the distant shore. You see, most of us never intentionally leave our faith. It's just a slow drift. Now you're ready for our focus, Isaiah 39 and 1. At that time, Merodach-Baladan, the son of Baladan, the king of Babylon, sent letters and a present to Hezekiah. So by the way, Babylon was not in ascendancy yet, but Babylon was an enemy of the Assyrians, and later the Babylonians would defeat them. It's a whole complicated thing. So the Babylonians are looking for allies, and everyone across the Middle East had heard about Hezekiah's miraculous recovery and healing. And in this moment, you know, the Babylonians, who often represent the world, they came to Judah because they were curious about Hezekiah's God. And they began to encourage, send gifts of encouragement to Hezekiah. But what you're going to see in a couple moments is, you know, he spent more time talking about his treasure than his God. But let's keep going. And Hezekiah was pleased with them. If he would have just prayed about this, if Hezekiah would have just asked the Lord about this instead of just asking himself about this. And when they came, he was like, finally, I'm getting some recognition. Finally, people are honoring me for all of the accomplishments, all the things that I've done for God. And when he came, you know, he fell over himself trying to impress the Babylonians with his power and his kingdom. And he showed them the house of his treasures. Here's what I know. You don't have to show everybody everything. You don't have to tell everybody everything. Typically, confidence is silence and insecurity is loud. Shh. He showed them the silver, the gold, the spices and precious ointment, and all his armory, all that was found among his treasures. Instead of teaching them about God, he just showed them his stuff. The man who had the faith to stare down 185,000 Assyrian soldiers melted like wax under flattery. I find the ultimate test of spirituality is not just how well you take criticism, but how well you take praise. It says there was nothing in his house or in all his dominion that Hezekiah did not show them. You see, it's natural for humans to want to be appreciated. This is natural, and typically there's nothing wrong with it. But Jesus speaks to this point, and he says sometimes it's best for the left hand not to know what the right hand is doing. Sometimes if God knows, it's enough. Then Isaiah the prophet went to the king Hezekiah, and we need men like this who will still speak the truth in love. We need folks that hear God and can communicate what God's saying, even though you don't necessarily applaud them when they leave the room. And they said to him, "What did these men say? And from where did they come to you?" So Hezekiah said, "Well, they came from a far country, from Babylon." And then he asked the question, What have they seen in your house? Hezekiah, did you cast your pearls before swine? Hezekiah, everything doesn't have to be on Facebook and Instagram. Hezekiah, some things are intended to be just between you and me. So Hezekiah answered honestly. He said, yes, instead of praying, I post it. How many of you, instead of praying, you post? And they have seen all that's in my house. There is nothing among my treasures that I have not shown them. Then Isaiah said to Hezekiah, hear the word of the Lord of hosts. Behold, the days are coming when all that is in your house and all that your fathers have accumulated over the centuries until this day shall be carried to Babylon. Those very people you wanted to impress, those people you got so busy with and cared so much about them seeing your glory versus you seeking the glory of God, they're going to end up doing what only people do. And if you want a trustworthy place to invest your time, it's God. But instead, he went on parade and started showing things he shouldn't show. And this is in my head, and I'm trying to formulate it in my mind before it comes out my mouth. I'm just going to say it before I think. But ladies, be careful about going around telling every woman about how great your husband is. Because like the Babylonians, they may come back. Everything's not everybody's business. I'm stuck there. Lord, help me, please. All right. There was a turtle. This turtle wanted to get to Florida, okay? And these two birds came up with this ingenious idea. And they put, actually, forgive me. See, I'm messing up the story. The turtle came up with this ingenious idea and talked the birds into it. And he said, well, I need to get to Florida, but what I want you to do is put a stick between your two beaks. And you know how slow I am. I'll you know, by the time I get there, you know, whatever I'm trying to get there for, it'll be over. So I want you to put the stick between your two beaks. And what I'm going to do is, I can't fly, is I'm going to bite the stick and hold on. And the birds, you know, started flapping and they started flying. It was amazing. The turtle was moving as fast as the birds could take them down to Florida. And someone on the ground looked up and said, what an ingenious idea. Who thought of transportation like this? I mean, who came up with such a great idea? And the turtle shouted, me. I had a hard time telling the story, but you know, our desire to receive praise can be our undoing. Our desire to want to take the credit can harm us.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Yes, and we pray that you learn something new that will help propel your relationship with God forward.
There's even more impactful teaching of God's Word on this YouTube channel. Click one of the videos on the screen to get even more. We hope to see you really soon right here at Grace Church.